Henry B. Curtis was born November 28, 1799, near Champlain, New York. In 1809, he and his family moved to Newark, Ohio. When Henry was 17, he traveled to Mount Vernon, Ohio, with only 25 cents in his pocket. He had come to Mount Vernon to study law with his older brother, Osmer Curtis. And in 1822, Henry succeeded at becoming a lawyer. On July 2, 1823, Henry married Elizabeth Hogg, and together they had 8 children, 6 boys and 2 girls. At the groundbreaking of the Ohio and Erie Canal, Mr. Curtis met Bishop Philander Chase. At the time, Bishop Chase was searching for a new location for his college. At Henry Curtis's suggestion, in 1825, both men rode on horseback to look at 8,000 acres that were available in Gambier, Ohio. Bishop Chase agreed that the land was ideal for his college, and is quoted as saying, "Well, this will do." In 1848, Henry formed the Knox County Bank and became its president. Today, that bank is known as First Knox National Bank. Henry was also the director of the Sandusky, Mansfield, and Newark Railroad, the first railroad that entered Mount Vernon. In the early 1850s, Henry began designing a home for his daughter Elizabeth and her husband John Gershop Plimpton. When Elizabeth's husband died, the building of the mansion known as Round Hill was completed by Mr. Curtis around 1860. About 1870, Round Hill became Henry's summer home. In 1975, the Mount Vernon News said Round Hill, a magnificent Italian villa which dominates the north side of Mount Vernon, beyond doubt is the grandest house in the county. In 1994, facts about Round Hill was printed in the Mount Vernon News and tells the reader that the main floor with its 15-foot ceilings includes a library, parlor, dining room that could serve 28 seated guests, and a servant sitting room. Door hardware in the home is silver, and fireplaces are made with marble from Italy, Scotland, and Ireland. Round Hill shows quality workmanship and features that were cutting edge of our domestic comfort in 1860. With 3 stories, 22 rooms, and 7,300 square feet, it took 4 years to build. It was at Round Hill in 1872 where Henry held a party for family and friends to announce his retirement from practicing law, a career that had lasted 50 years. However, he was not done serving. In the spring of 1873, Mr. Curtis received an appointment from President Grant to become a member of the Board of Visitors at West Point. Henry B. Curtis constructed few houses in Mount Vernon, and in 1876, he constructed the Curtis House Hotel. Sadly, however, in 1946, it fell to a devastating fire. In 2013, Ariel Corporation purchased the property, and in 2015, will have completed a new hotel very similar in design to Henry Curtis's original hotel. November 5, 1885, Mr. Curtis passed away in Chicago, Illinois. Among the many successes listed in his life, it was also said of him by A.R. McIntyre that, in contact with his fellow men, he accorded to all alike the same kind, cordial reception, and considerate attention.